Welcome, Freunde. It's me again, Jessica, in my studio, and we're gonna paint on a brown base and try to do some abstract art. The pillow paint I'm using is a Sherwin-Williams Color to Go sample quart of the color Black Bean Soup. I gotta admit, I just got it because of the name. My canvas is a cradled board 14 by 18 inches big. I spin it on my baby spinner that I have extended a little bit just to see how big I can build the extensions and it still works properly. The colors I'm using are teal by golden, interference gold by this little piggy called ball gown. I'm using JoSonja plum pink, and I'm using permanent blue violet by Amsterdam. So the color to go colors are a little bit thinner than I used to be. I'm not as fond of them as I used to be because they're way too thin, and you can tell, especially in this painting, how they eat up the paints on top. While a white pillow would rather mix in with the colors, my colors here tend to just sink down, if that makes sense. And I'm pretty sure it's due to its thinnosity. So I'll add some swipes with the same color scheme, and then I will go in with my black in a squeeze bottle and do some contrasting lines. I will keep scooping and dragging, and the whole thing is a surprise to me as much as it to you. This is the fun part of knowing what you're doing. Once you're confident with the technique you're working in, you're open to do anything. That's when the fun begins. If you need help getting your recipe right, swiping, scooping and dragging, transfer swiping, anything, I will be in Seattle at the next Fluidart Experience teaching very fun courses. And if you get the chance, go ahead, book a class with me or one of the other amazing artists. It's just such a wonderful community, and I'm so excited to see you all again. You can use the link in my description box. Or just go to fluidartexperience.com. Check it all out. They have a discounted hotel rate right now. I will put that one in the description box as well. Yeah, otherwise, enjoy this. I will show you parts of the end result because, again, I started painting on this. If you're a patron or a channel member, you get to see how I painted and what I painted and what a struggle it was. I'm just getting it back into painting. I used to paint a lot, but I haven't in the last years because of obvious reasons. And I keep realizing it is practice that you need most. And I don't have that, so I'm working on that. Enjoy this painting. I'm trying to let go again. I'm trying to do new things. Get into different habits, forget my old habits, and see what happens. Okay, see you in a minute.
Thank you.
break, my dear friends. This is it. Spun out. You saw that I put on some transfer swipes, and my intention is to add some more depth to it, so the transferred parts are gonna be seen better. I will show you just a little bit of what I painted so far. Actually, I'm a little bit further. I had a bunch of power outages, like you maybe realized in my last life. So sorry about that. We got cut off halfway through. So there's a bunch that I have not filmed. And I'm realizing how crazy it is to be painting with a brush again. It's such a different way to apply paint. And especially acrylics is so frustrating sometimes because you have to work in layers since most of the paints are transparent. So I have to white some parts out to apply some colored paint on top so it actually keeps its intensity or becomes more intense. So this is crazy. And like I said, I've done way more already. If you're curious, stop by my Patreon page or keep your eyes peeled. I might post something on Instagram about it. This is for now what you get. I'm very curious about how far I can take this. Guys, this was fun. Check out the Seattle Fluid Art Experience event. Check out my spinner. Give me a like. Maybe subscribe. Anything you do helps me a lot. See you next week. Until then, bye-bye.